girls. Welcome to peek over my shoulder as I mosey about in Call of Pripyat in a very casual manner. I'm currently waiting for a daybreak in Jupiter, and I got a little antsy, and so I figured I would come to the factory complex and do stuff in the interiors and stuff. And also I figured that I would check out try to check out some of the stashes in the factory area. I mean, deeper inside the factory. I know there's this one nearby that I didn't pick up earlier. Anything in this tree? Doesn't seem so. And also I made a strategic decision that while I still am kind of avoiding all mission sensitive or story sensitive stuff, more like avoiding interacting with it, I could still pick up the Strelok's group stashes, because I don't think they trigger anything. And also I can't avoid triggering shit forever, because if I do that, then some of the zone dynamics won't kick in. Because right now it seems that the mutant life is very quiet, there aren't any big mutants roaming about and all that, so I need to start addressing some of it at some point. Okay, I have been here already. Let's go back downstairs. Last time I think some dogs followed me here. What time is it? Nearly 3. We are making progress in the whole daybreak situation. Oh, and also while I was getting antsy before I went and picked up the sniper rifle from the train top. So that is also stashed with the rest of my doodads in the depot thingy. Well, let's see if I can trigger the whole chair thing. Because even though I think it has to be on its back, and then you have to just walk into it gently. I myself have never been able to reliably replicate the chair glitch. I think in Call of Pripyat I might have a few times, but in Shadow of Chernobyl it has never worked for me. For example, I dragged like a whole bunch of chairs onto the south gate at Cordon in the hopes of getting over the perimeter wall, and even though they do give some slight physics glitching, they never quite launch me high. Of course, there is one crucial difference: the chairs in Call of Pripyat do this glitchy sound, while the chairs in Shadow of Chernobyl never do. Well, for me at least. Allegedly the chair in Freedom Base does glitch out and gets you into the armory. Again, it has never worked for me. grenade jump person myself. And breaking doors open with rifles kind of person. Hello. Ah, I think I'm getting the bandits here. Or maybe a zombie fight? I don't know. Okay. Thing is, I don't actually fully remember what was the path to the to the complex proper. The darkness doesn't help right now. Like, was it the case of just walking there, or was it the case have to go through another building and then yet another? Ah, okay. Yeah. Duh. Anything of interest in the garage? Nope. I'm not going to trigger the helicopters, at least not now. But I am going to poke around and pick up other stuff. If I do find any. Ah, yeah, this is the one way out, so I have to get in from the other side. There are pseudodogs about. Quick save, because I don't want to wait another half of night. Oh, see, it's already 3:30. You see, right now the primary objective of what I'm doing is just to wait until the daybreak, until I can start exploring proper. Oh, the sky is getting lighter-ish. And while I'm here, I am going to check the S.T.A.L.K.E.R stash as well. In fact, let's do that right now. Because I want to be on higher ground when the hounds show up. Ow. You live. Okay, let's just take everything out. Yoink. Yeah, they seem to be awfully fond of the chemical anomalies, because the one of the other letters is also behind these, behind chemistry. pick up the monolith stash as well. Let's see. Okay. Okay, I think the radiation here is too strong for just the jellyfish, so I'm gonna leave that for another time. Drink up. Let's find ourselves a different object to lean onto. Woohoo! And check other stashes. Hot. I mean, everything is. Ah, okay, this is the gate that I commented on in the Twilight Zone. Lunch or early breakfast. Vodka, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. I really need to get a good shotgun. By good, I mean with a big magazine. Ah, hot, 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 hot. Anything to declare? Stash in here, maybe. Also hot, hot, hot. Ow. If you're gonna irradiate yourself, could you do it without falling down? Radiation status. Okay, we can handle it. Yeah, that's the structure in the Twilight Zone. Hello. Because this way I will free up my inventory a little bit. Ah, so these boxes do the physics glitch as well, technically speaking. Dawning. Goody. And I think I hear a burner. anything that the bolts don't trigger the burnt fuzz at all. I guess it's more of a living thing than a proper anomaly. Let's not pick up any unknown documents. Right now, I mean. Yeah. So this one will be saved for later. I'm only interested in stashes right now. Otherwise, so let's leave them alone. To this door here, although I don't think it, since it doesn't function as a door, I don't think it will work anyway. Almost daylight, yo. Piper's Place. Anything in here? Nope. Is not optimal for mutant infestation, but we will manage. Sometimes the red pearls don't disappoint. Oh, I'm in the Psydog range. Too bad I can't just kick in a vent and crawl in that way. One of the main pseudodogs only shows up once you examine the chopper. Or maybe I'm remembering that wrong. The classic 3-liter jar. It's a Soviet thing. Not as hot as the others. Huh, the roof is so close. Interesting. Now, if one had, say, a grenade launcher, one might almost make a jump to the roof from here. Although this ledge is at a very very bad position, like if you don't make the jump, then you're gonna slam yourself into it and get killed and such. Remember if that door was like breakable or what. Let's not touch any secret documents. Whoa, that's some very light PC. I'm only here for stashes right now. Do not touch. To remember there was a stash in the chopper room though. Something think it was a rifle jammed under a shelf or something. One of those a little bit difficult to find pieces. Or at least I think it was difficult to find with the stash marker, because it seemed as if the stash is elsewhere. I came in? Yeah. Okay, let's get back to the other area. If I go here, then I get the pseudo or the Psy Dog influence, so I can't be too far from the chopper. But I think even during my first playthrough, I was able to watch up the navigation in this area. Like there was this one area that I missed completely, and then the other that I just kept looping back into. This room, and there was this other ladder that I had to climb, wasn't it? Yeah, so the other area is there, of course. I know I can't get back otherwise, other than I have to circle back in. Yeah, it's starting to come back to me. Oop, oop, oop. Oh, what's our status? Let's put. Oh, this is. Okay. I totally didn't know this. I think that was the truck then, the truck cabin. This is a very, very fine fighting indeed. Right, so we go from here, up here, all the way through here, 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 here. Ignore the documents, and now end back in there. And I know why I keep, and in the past kept missing it, because I sort of, my brain mashed it together with the other area. But of course this is where we get to the chopper. How much ammo do I have? 20. Huh. I think that was the original. Like if you spend enough time here, it starts sending copies to you as well, but this was the original. Oh. Oh. What? Fuck. to self. There can be more than one pseudo dog at a time. Same for psi dogs. Okay, let's do the eating part now. Eat. Doggy. Ah, fuck, these are both copies. Original, but the one on the left is. This is not. That is. No. Well, fuck. Definitely made this more difficult for myself than I should have. Don't touch the chopper. Not yet. Not now. We will do a whole chopper round later on. Also examine the possibility of getting to the roof, because fun. So let's see, I think a nice grenade jump, I mean, and in this case a nice launcher grenade jump might actually do the trick here. Because you might only need like a little boost. Anything on top of that shelf? Nope. Anything on top of that tank? Nope. I've used the tool up already, so maybe it's better if I swap for rifle at the moment. Yes. Now let's see, anything at top of the shelf? No. Anything in the stove? Doesn't seem so. Anything in that stove or frying pan or whatever? No. Anything up in the vents? Can't even tell if it's like kitchen proper or more like science cooking stuff. Cooking with science. You should be able to get up there. Like, totally. Huh. Oh, well. Let's just examine from the ground. Okay, this is where we're getting out already, so not going out yet. Let's go back in there and pick up that other stash. Other one. Are they different from the regular? Nah. Just pseudo dog. I want to murder the other books. That one, yes. Now, yeah, here it is. Yoink. Leave the possibilities of roof exploration for some other time, not today. Today it's all about stashes. Anything under the stove? Nope. Back in the day, I'm not sure about Jupiter. I know that I was never able to find all Zaton stashes, and in my current game I have already found more than I did in my original game. I mean, without getting stash info and such. But in Jupiter I'm not sure one of the very insidious places, sneaky hiding places, is the top of something. Here as well. Again, not today's agenda. Pipe tops are always very suspect. Ah yeah, this is where we get the glimpse of the underpass. That's the way out. This is one of those trucks that you don't trust. Crate to make a comfy jump into it. Crate or a nice red barrel. Location which we are not picking up. And we can't activate this right now, so let's not. I thought that I saw a box of ammo, but nope. What's that? Ah, oh, that's just a thingy in the control panel. Let's go say hi to the monolith tea cozy. course, this is where I last saved. So where to? Through here. Over here. Over here. Did I pick up the stash? Of course I didn't. Damn it. Become forgetful in my old age. I used to quick save every time after a past win in game, but now I just sort of, whatever. Well, in fact, I used to manual save every time I passed win in game. Oh yeah, let's switch to this for now. Because okay, so let's throw it from this side and then let's get behind the concrete thingy. Me, monolith. Tell me what's the weather. Why are you silent, monolith? I want to leave something here. Something. Let's leave a vodka here. Okay, I can proceed now. Have been any stashes in this area as well? Can't remember. Can't remember shit. Seem to have come down with a case of amnesia. Anyway, I think for now we are done here. Let's go outside, enjoy what's left of the daylight. Which is to say, not much. Check that doohickey. And I'm not picking up any strange documents for now. Anything in the truck? Nope. I'll probably return to this location for other fun activities and maybe some launcher grenades just in case. Damn, the daylight isn't all that's advertised. Well then, I think my whole check some stashes at the Jupiter complex goal has been fulfilled, and I'm gonna end this episode here. Thank you very much for watching. Bye bye, and see you some other time.